Why is it so important to improve science education and education in general?
Well, for education in general, I mean, I think of you sort of as how can you improve the human condition? Education kind of is at the top of the list of what sorts of things people can do that ultimately improve their lives. And so I see education as very fundamental and important. Now, why science education is important is just because in modern societies, science and technology have just become so pervasive that there's so many times that in one's personal life and in one's workplace that you're going to encounter issues of science and technology, that having basic knowledge about it is going to be beneficial to almost everyone.
And what do you believe is the problem with education today, and what are some of the key elements that we know about how people learn?
So what I would say is the biggest problem with education today is it's sort of the fundamental paradigm of how people think about learning. And I think that goes back to a very ancient view, which is the monks were given lectures and they copied down that information, that people still think of learning as just filling up the brain with knowledge, and that that's an education. Whereas modern research shows learning is about changing the brain, really developing new capabilities in it through rewiring how the synapses are hooked up. And so I think the most important step is to people to adjust to this new way of thinking of what you're trying to accomplish in the learning and the education, and then how to achieve that and getting to this developing the brains of students, as opposed to just saying, okay, I'm going to feed them knowledge and that'll sink in to some amount.
And how can we better teach problem solving, understanding and applying the relevant information to enable better decision making?
So I think there one needs to look at, okay, so how do you develop the brain in the most effective way? And I think this is very analogous to building up a muscle, that, you know, if you want to make a muscle stronger, you need to exert that muscle and you need to do it strenuously over a long period of time. And what we now understand is developing the brain is in much the same way. Good education has to give the learner authentic problems where they have to practice doing the thinking that you want them to master. They've got to practice that thinking. They have to get feedback on how they're doing and how to improve it, and then they have to practice it some more. And that's really the ongoing process of practice and feedback developing these capabilities that you want in that educated mind.
And what are some of the most common misconceptions that students often have about learning, and how can we address them?
You know, that's a difficult one to say for sure, but I'll give you one important misconception, which is that they think that learning should be easy, and that if you study something and it's not easy, then, well, your brain just isn't capable of learning it, and so you kind of give up. Whereas the fact is that good learning requires strenuous mental effort for everyone, and students have to sort of be led to understand that they should expect it to be difficult, and they should expect to have to put in serious effort to learn it, to achieve mastery.